to defeat your fear of snakes.
Have you ever found yourself frozen by the sight of a snake? And it seems like you don't know what to do? Suddenly, you feel your cold sweat all over your face. And you're hoping that you don't get bitten and die. Perhaps you have a fear of snakes. Let's talk about that in this video. Welcome to How to Defeat Your Fear of Animals series. This is the Life Hack Lion, the channel that gives you amazing life hacks and interesting facts. Make sure to watch this video till the end because the last step helped me a lot to defeat my fears of snake. The fear of snakes, or ophidiophobia, is the most common phobia in existence. A phobia, in general, is an uncontrollable, irrational, and persistent fear of something, while ophis is a Greek word that refers to a serpent. So, ophidiophobia is the irrational and uncontrollable fear of snakes. Fear of snakes is incredibly prevalent that nearly two-thirds of adults in the world experience some form of anxiety when dealing with snakes. Different people have different levels of fear of snakes. Fortunately, there is a way to overcome that fear so you will not just freeze upon seeing a snake, but you will know what to do. Bear with me as I lead you through each step to defeating your fear of snakes. Before we get started, please get a pen and a piece of paper because you need to be taking notes on this. You can pause this video to give yourself time to get them. So, you have them now? Okay, let's get started. Step number one, understand your fear of snakes. There is an ongoing debate on whether the fear of snakes is a learned fear or one formed over millions of years of evolution. You may have developed your fear of snakes if you have personally been threatened or have witnessed a threatening event. Also, you might have learned to be afraid of snakes from popular film and television, books, social media, or even word of mouth. Regardless of the root cause, your fear of snakes has the power to override your ability to think rationally. If even the concept, suggestion, or image of a snake can cause you an extreme reaction beyond the logical scope of the scenario, you can be suffering from ophidiophobia. If that is the case, it is best to seek the help of a professional. However, it is also important to note that you don't have to be diagnosed with ophidiophobia to want to overcome your fear of snakes. Step number two, confronting your fear of snakes. In this step, you need to write down first everything about snakes that scares you. Ask yourself, what is it about them that scares you? What are your thoughts about them? Try to describe a snake. Then, identify your type of fear. Were you given scary information about the behavior of snakes? Do you hate the way they look? Have you been bitten by a snake? If you have been traumatized by personal experience, you may need to undergo counseling before seeking out any type of therapy. However, if your fear of snakes is caused by misinformation and popular media, knowing exactly why you are afraid of snakes can help you overcome your fear. Step number three, know more about snakes. Here, you should learn as much as you can about snakes. You can begin by researching facts about snakes. As an introduction, here are some facts about snakes. According to the National Geographic Society, there are more than 3,000 species of snakes all over the world, and they are found everywhere except in Antarctica, Iceland, Ireland, Greenland, and New Zealand. About 600 species are venomous, and only about 7% of the total number of species can kill or significantly wound a human. Most snakes live on land, but there are about 70 species of snakes that live in the Indian and Pacific Oceans. Sea snakes and their cousins, krates, are some of the most venomous snakes that exist, but they pose little threat to humans because they're shy, gentle, and their fangs are too short to do much damage. Did you know that snakes are more afraid of you than you are of them? Snakes may sense humans as threats as they view us as a potentially dangerous predator. They will defend themselves if they feel threatened, but if you leave them alone, they will leave you alone too. Once you have done your research, assess if your assumptions about snakes are correct. Then analyze if your fears are justified. If you have learned to be afraid of snakes from popular media or word of mouth, you should start unlearning these fears by knowing some hard facts. Step number 4, desensitize yourself. First, practice deep breathing relaxation. Sit in a chair that can support your back and be sure that you are comfortable with your position. Put one of your hands on your chest and your other hand on your stomach. Take one slow deep breath in through your nose while counting to 4. Then, hold your breath while counting to 7. And exhale through your mouth while you count to 8. Repeat these steps as needed. Next is to search a photo of a snake on the internet and then print it out. Here, the exercise is for you to look at the picture and determine your anxiety level. On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 representing virtually no anxiety while 10 reflecting extreme anxiety, rate how much anxiety you experience by looking at the picture. As you do it, try to keep yourself calm by doing deep breathing relaxation. Perhaps 10 to 15 minutes is a reasonable amount of time to do this daily activity. Also, do not forget to write in your journal where you are on the anxiety scale. When you reach 1 or 2 on the scale, that is your signal to move on to the next step. Next is to watch videos of snakes. Look for videos or documentaries of snakes on the internet. By doing this, you should be able to familiarize yourself with the snake as best as you can by observing how they move, socialize, and act. The same when you are looking at a picture of a snake. Here, you should also determine and record your anxiety level. If needed, still practice deep breathing relaxation. Only move on to the next step if you feel little to no anxiety while looking at the videos of the snakes. Lastly, try to handle a toy snake. Don't worry, we'll take this slowly. You can begin with a stuffed animal that appears less threatening or that is cute and cuddly. Still, you should record your anxiety level in your journal. When you don't feel anxious anymore, you can then proceed to handling a rubber replica that looks like a real snake. Step number 5, making physical contact. Relax, we'll take this slowly. Your first exercise is to observe a living snake. If you have a friend that keeps a snake as a pet, then please contact that friend. If not, you could try visiting your local pet store to see if they have any snakes for sale. Okay, calm down. You are not buying one. Instead, you will be watching the snake safely from the other side of the glass. If you have a zoo near you, then better. Try to visit their reptile exhibit. Then, pay attention to the snake's movement and apply what you have learned from your research. Perhaps you know that if the snake is coiled up, it may be cold and trying to maintain its body temperature. Also, notice your reaction and rate it based on the anxiety scale. If you feel anxious, remember your deep breathing relaxation. Once you feel comfortable observing a snake, it's up to you to go further and get even closer to a snake. When you are ready, you can even try to handle a living snake. Just be sure to talk to the animal handler first and let him or her teach you how to properly handle the snake. If you notice yourself having no anxiety by looking at a snake or even handling it, congratulations! Because you have defeated your fear of snakes. Remember, you need to practice regularly. The only way it's going to be successful is if you keep it up. If at all possible, practice daily. And if needed, you can also build a reward system so you will be encouraged to work towards each step. If you're having a hard time doing all of these alone, you can seek a therapist to help you conquer your fear of snakes. Do you know some other tips for defeating one's fear of snakes? Or do you have any requests for our next video? Let us know in the comment section below. If you find this video interesting, we'd love you to support us for more life hacks and interesting facts.